Weeks 1 and 2 of this marathon block for Manchester were largely based around endurance and starting to lay the foundations to build upon. A new week is here and it's time to add some tempo into the mix and also dreaded intervals. Welcome to week 3 of Project 342.
Welcome to the first run of week 3. Just got back from work and I went straight to the porch, got my shoes on, and I'm out the door for a run before dinner, before I've had time to talk myself out of going for today's run. So let's get this one done and let's get week 3 off to a flyer. I'm going to do a bit of a deal with myself. So I'm going to do a bit of a... Right, try again. This goes up in 5 seconds with my mother. Hello, is anybody there?
Run out of battery multiple times because, well, GoPro. I'm going to make a bit of a deal with myself. Over the next, well, every 3 weeks, I think, I'm going to run that exact same route that I ran today. Between 6 minutes and 6 minutes 10, which is kind of an easy effort for me. And I want to see, every time I do it, the difference in heart rate, if I can run to that pace. And I want to see if I can nudge that heart rate down towards the early 140s. Now that would be the dream. To think today's average heart rate was about 150. And yeah, the dream would be early 140s, late 130s, but maybe that's gonna take a longer time than 15, 16 weeks. But anyway, today's run went well and nice and easy one to start the week. Let's get a bit speedier tomorrow. No, rest day tomorrow. Bit speedier Wednesday. Yeah.
Oh, look at that, the water's creeping up. It's coming to get us. So it's Wednesday, and I'm looking at something. My intervals playlist on Spotify. Master of Puppets, Down With The Sickness, Chop Suey, bit of System of a Down, Night Train, Guns N' Roses, Get Your Hands Off My Woman, The Darkness. Wow, always makes you run faster. Today, it's a speedy day. Haven't done any speed since my 5K park run PB just over 2 weeks ago. So haven't run faster than 5 minute Ks or 8 minutes a mile for just over 2 weeks. So I don't know how today's gonna go. I'm just gonna walk this and tell you this. It's a big day because I'm trying out some new shoesies. Got the Adidas Takumi Sen 8s on. Today's objective is, well, I'm just running, this is technically my warm up. And then we're gonna go into 6 intervals, trying to hit a pace of between 4 minutes and 4 minutes 10, so that's faster than my 5K pace. 3 minutes of them, 2 minutes walking slash dying recoveries, and then depending how much further I fancy running in these and what I've got left in the tank, it might turn into a bit of a fartlek session, and I'll see how these feel at different paces. And one last thing, last week I was banging on about heart rate. And today I finally, you can't see it, I finally got a heart rate strap on. So thank you so much to me old mucker, Kieran Turner, for sending me one of his old ones for me to test. I'm just gonna see how it feels first before I purchase one. But I think I'm gonna enjoy it. So, right, gonna do a 10 minutes in total of warm up. Let's see if we can hit these paces. When that System of a Down kicks in, hopefully it's going to give me a few extra seconds of speed. Here we go then. So, I don't know if I'm shouting or not because I'm listening to Metallica, so I'm trying to complete with Kirk Hammett. 10 seconds, here we go again. What do you listen to when you do your speed workouts? Do you go au naturel? Or is it classical? A little bit of Verdi or Brahms. Maybe a cheeky bit of Mozart. Here we go again. See if we can hit 4 minutes to 4:10. Struggling to hit these paces. Probably because they're really fast. Come on. Come on. Stop making excuses. Here we go again, come on. No excuses. Get over yourself, Andy, and run. I love running fast, but I also hate it. Nah, don't be silly, I love it, but I hate it. If there's one interval I should hit, it's this one, because this one is all downhill. If I don't do this, I'm struggling. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow. That felt really good. Oh man. I would love to run a 5K at that pace one day. Oh wow. System of the Dam is going mental in my ear. Come on. That was hard. Slowest one yet. Let's finish in style. I know that I'm nowhere near a sub 20 minute 5k. It's because I can't even jog easy or even zone one. My recoveries, I'm all out for that 3 minutes. What's that, 700 meters? I'm all out. So that's how I know I'm nowhere near. Tomorrow is a rest day. I'll talk to you about the rest of the shoes that I'm using as part of this Manchester training rotation. See you tomorrow.
Why do, it's not a pick and mix, mate, it's a bag of wood. What have you got there? So naughty.
Right, I shall do this to the best of my ability because there's a little dog around here somewhere who likes to do other things with running shoes than wear them. She likes to, well, eat them. So let's go through these shoes. I've got seven shoes in my Manchester rotation. I've grouped them into three sections, easy, trails, and faster shoes. So let's go through from, well, basically the lower end to the faster end, what I'm gonna be using. I'll try and make this as quickly as possible. One of my newest additions, I bought the Nike Invincible 2s in sort of a khaki green. Amazing shoes. Absolutely love swallowing up miles in this. It's got ZoomX foam in it, and they're just so comfortable, so bouncy, so cushioned. So absolutely love them. And these, believe it or not, are very, very speedy. So you don't have to just go slow in these. You can go right the way through the paces. For me, she's fine. I just, because she's new around here, I never know if she's, her new thing is eating the remote control. So if Phil and Holly just randomly appear, that's because she's just pressed the on button. Yeah, really good shoe. Would massively recommend this, this shoe. Really, really nice. I use this for predominantly easy and recoveries. When it's really, really miserable outside, muddy, whatever, I'll probably wear these, which are my Puma Velocity, and they need a bit of a clean, what they're called, Puma Velocity Nitro 2s. I think that's what they're called. Velocity Nitro 2s, yeah. They do a very, very similar job to the Invincibles. I have these for my Amsterdam rotation for exactly the same job as what the Nikes are doing, and love them, still love them. You'll see me wearing these for the occasional parkrun sandwich or the occasional long run. I just really like them, so I will flip and switch between these two. I'll probably wear these 75% of long runs and this maybe 25%. Moving on to trails. These, I absolutely love these. These are my Reebok Floatride Energy Adventures. They've all got such strange names, haven't they? And absolutely love them. Now, I wear these for hybrids. So, for example, parkrun is a perfect example when you're running through mud fields, but you have to go through tarmac paths and roads to get there. I'll wear this shoe. It's a really, really light shoe as well. And yeah, huge fan of this Reebok trail shoe. For muddy trails, I will wear this. I ran my 50K ultramarathon in this, the Worcestershire Way, which is the Nike Wild Horse 6. And yes, super muddy trails, I'll wear this. It is, I'd say it's not a hybrid shoe, but it doesn't do too badly on asphalt. So yeah, I wouldn't worry too much about wearing this on the road. But when it comes to hybrids, I'd wear this. Muddy trails, this. Moving on to the faster stuff. Now, I bought this trainer again, which is the Floatride, Reebok Floatride Energy 4. Obviously not the trail version. And it's a really good shoe, but I'm struggling to where to put it now because of this shoe that I bought yesterday, that I wore for the first time yesterday, which is the Adidas Takumi Sen 8. This will probably be for tempos rather than intervals, which is what I wanted to use it for. It's a good shoe, it's just not as good as this thing. Now this Takumi Sen 8, you saw me wearing it yesterday, it's just so snappy, it's amazing, it's so lightweight. I really, really liked it. It's one of those shoes that sort of lived up to the hype, I guess you could say. I've only worn it for 10K, so what do I know? Come and ask me in 100K's time. But a lot of people like this shoe, and I can see myself really enjoying wearing this for intervals, time trials, 5K races, 10K races, maybe even further than that. Some people say don't wear it for anything more than 10K. My mate Brett, who you know, for he's been on the channel loads of times, he's worn this for half marathons, says it's fine. So you've got to try these things. If you don't try these things, then you'll never know. So this is for faster efforts. This, I will work out where to put this. It's not a huge amount of money wasted if I don't end up using this to its maximum potential. I picked it up for about 45 quid on the Reebok website. Still a really good shoe. So yeah, maybe tempo park runs in the fairer weather. But at the moment, I'm not going to buy any more shoes. Can't make any promises. But it's going to be the Nike Vaporfly that I will be running Manchester in. The reason I bought these is to take the heat off these, because when I do time trials and, you know, faster efforts, long run efforts, whatever, I'll probably wear these than these, just to save, you know, putting, not junk miles, but just to save putting an unnecessary miles in this shoe. So yeah, that's where this one will come in for. To substitute when I want to wear this for shorter efforts, because now I'm retiring it for half marathons and marathon races almost exclusively only. So there you go, there are my seven shoes that I'll be running the Manchester rotation in. There could be additions, I can't rule that out. I'm addicted to shoes. There are more shoes in my wardrobe and in the shoe rack than my wife has. I'm addicted to buying shoes. I make no apologies for that. Anyway, see you on tomorrow's run. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to be doing tomorrow. Probably will be to do with one of these two. See you then.
All my local routes are flooded at the moment, which is good for me because it makes me get out of my comfort zone and makes me explore some different routes, really, because I'm a creature of habit and I just end up running the same routes over and over again. So it's good to do a bit of exploring. But yeah, look at Worcestershire. Absolutely underwater at the moment. Hopefully that's the worst of it for a while. Happens every year, sometimes 3, 4, 5 times a year. So we're used to it around here. So let's crack on and get this week's mileage up to 55k. Still got another couple of runs to do first, but let's get Friday's run done. Here we go. Half k, zone 2-ish, and I think we're done for Friday.
See you tomorrow for a bit of parkrun tourism. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to a bit of parkrun tourism. I'm in zone 5. I'm struggling. It's a proper parkrun, this one. And I mean proper parkrun. Ludlow over in Shropshire. Because Worcester's underwater. So, fancied a bit of a change. So here we are. And it's awesome. Thank you, mate. Ludlow parkrun, 10 out of 10. That was awesome. Thank you, everyone. So there we have it. There's the Ludlow parkrun done. That was really tough. I started off quite well, actually. I think I'd got about a 5-minute K, but then it just went, my times went downhill from there, but the course went uphill. It was undulating, so I shouldn't have known, because there was equally enough downhill, but some really muddy sections, but that was really fun. And as parkruns go, that was a real proper park run. No running on tarmac around a park. This is a proper forest trail, and that was really fun. So now we're going to explore a bit of Ludlow, and really glad we made the effort to come up here, because it was really fun. I think I might have a crack at coming here in the summer to see if I can improve on that time. But yeah, a lot of fun. Would heartily recommend. Donnelly fish and chips, sublime. Best fish and chips in Worcester. It's controversial. Anyway, so today I'm going to be working in blocks of 4. Starting off easy on today's Sunday long run. And we're going to be doing 4Ks nice and easy, which is about six, I'm just slow down, about 6:10 pace. Then the next 4, I'm going to go a bit quicker and do a 4-hour marathon pace, which is 5:40 pace. And then next 4 after that, I'm going to go to goal marathon pace, which is actually a tempo pace. Even though it's goal marathon pace, at the moment it's tempo. So 4 of them, and we'll coast home with the rest being easy. Hopefully we're going to get about 16-17 k's done today, and that'll take us up to 55, which is the target for week 3. So let's go get them ran. That's why parkrun was cancelled. Tempo time. Let's pick it up. Tempo lap 1, 5:06. 5:05 again, too fast again. Tempo lap 3, coming up. We're up 3. You can see a theme developing here. 2, blooming fast. Just slow it down, 3 or 4 seconds. Doesn't sound a lot, but when there's 42 lots of these, they all add up. Come on, 5:10. Yes, 5:10. Well, technically 5:11 is my target marathon pace, but 5:10 will do just nicely. So let's switch over the watch to measure my zones, and then it's zone 2 all the way home, and that is not a problem here. talk to you guys about is bridging the gap between easy and your goal marathon pace. Now for me, there's like a minute difference. There's like a minute of no man's land basically. And there's a bit of a tendency not to run in that sort of gray area. Because for me, easy for me is anywhere between 6:10, 6:40, in that sort of 30 second area. And then marathon pace is like, what, 5:10, 5:11, that's the goal. So do you train in that gray area? Well, yes, I think you should, because there's a long way in between those two numbers. And the way I bridged that gap today was last marathon pace, just 5:40, which is a 4-hour marathon. And for me, that was the best way to do it. So I did 4K marathon pace, 4K just before that, last year's marathon pace, which is 30 seconds slower. And then before that was easy, and this is super easy because we're in zone two. So yes, bridging that gap, should you run in that gray area? I do. And for me, that seems to be the logical way to leapfrog into that new marathon pace. So that's how I do it. Right folks, so that's the end of another video. Thank you so much for watching and sticking to the end. I massively value all of you guys that watch these videos. It keeps me motivated and keeps me inspired to keep going for it. Week three's been good. Approximately 55K. Each week I'm trying to incrementally increase the distance by 5K at a time, 10%-ish. And then peak week, or the peak 3 weeks, which is about 2 months from now, I'll be doing almost double the volume at 100K, which will be, well, never ever will have run that volume in my life. So I'm excited for that. But as for now, I think we've done enough for this week. Got some intervals in earlier on in the week. Done some easy running, bit of tempo today, some marathon pace, and some lovely easy miles just to finish. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Take it easy wherever you are in the world. Ta-da.